let's get to the medical part of things. One is, you know, I have a severe history of allergies, and my doctor said I should not get the vaccine.
Unless you have a very specific allergy to one of the components in the vaccine, you are fine. It is recommended to have that vaccine in a medical setting, so, you know, you're watched for a little bit longer, just to make sure you don't have a reaction. But it is completely fine and safe to get the vaccine, any of the vaccines, even with severe allergies.
What about people who think that their doctor has told them, you know, you can't get the vaccine because of your medical illnesses? Are there any medical illnesses that would prevent you from getting a vaccine?
Actually, probably in your best interest to get the vaccine, because if you have any medical reason that puts you at higher risk for, you know, if you were to get COVID, you really want the vaccine. So there's no reason you can't get it.
The other one I heard is if I have somebody who's immunocompromised at home, I shouldn't get the vaccine.
You cannot get COVID from the vaccine, and you can't spread COVID to anybody else. So you're not spreading any of the virus because there is no virus in the vaccine.
Lots of things on the side effects. I think that's really what's scaring people the most, right? There's just enough out there. I know you mentioned that the overall incidence is really low, but it's still a concern. Can you tell us about that?
Obviously, you're going to hear about the scary things that are out there, and they are scary. You know, there's a couple, you know, the blood clots. There's a syndrome where you get thrombosis and thrombocytopenia syndrome. Again, sounds horrendous, and it is, but again, extremely uncommon. What they saw is women 18 to 48, and again, very rare, about one in a million or something like that, they were getting these syndromes. So maybe for the, if you were a woman in that age range, maybe choose to get one of the other ones. But even if you got the J&J vaccine, again, the risk is so very low. And with all these things, you always have to remember, if you were to get COVID disease itself, you're more likely to get those things. So you're more likely to get blood clots and other dangerous things if you get COVID. There are a couple others. You may have heard of myocarditis. Again, seems to occur with adolescent boys, actually, after their second shot. And this is an inflammation of the heart. Again, sounds really scary, but tends to be mild and self-limited. And again, if you get COVID itself, you're much more likely to get myocarditis.
Talk to me about long COVID. I know we've got different names, long haulers and long COVID, but we do know there's long-term complications from having COVID. What we've heard is that maybe the vaccine actually, one, it prevents, you know, severe illness in the first place, but for people that have had COVID who have these long hauler symptoms, that the vaccine may actually be helpful.
This virus is so inflammatory, it causes such an inflammatory reaction in your blood vessels, in your organs. It's all over, you know, in your lungs. So by you getting the vaccine, you're building an immunity. So hopefully, if there was any residual response from COVID, this will help get you better.
How about emergency use authorization? You know, people really want to make sure that the FDA fully approves it. What's your feeling on that?
The emergency use authorization, again, some people say maybe it should be a different name because it sounds like, oh, we're just doing this in an emergency. We're not really, you know, vetting this or studying it enough, when that's really not the case. In order for something to be FDA licensed or approved, they actually, so for a vaccine or any biological, they have to, not just the product, but the building where it's at and any supplier. So they have to certify all those places, make sure that it's all consistent. And that takes time. They haven't pulled this emergency use authorization. If there was any concern, they would pull that and it would not be authorized at all.
It's still a relatively new vaccine. How do we know long term that we're not going to have consequences of that?
So in the history of all vaccines ever made, any bad side effect, and things have happened, they tend to occur within the first 2 months. We've had hundreds of millions of doses of these vaccines, you know, administered around the world. And really, any of the effects that we've noticed, they've all occurred in that time frame. And, you know, we use this VAERS system, that's a, you know, vaccine adverse events reporting system. People are, you know, saying, well, look, things are popping up. And that's exactly right. That it's doing exactly what it's supposed to do. It's finding things that are so rare, it would be very hard to note it otherwise. So this is a great system, and it's working exactly like it should.
What's your advice for people still a little afraid?
Everything that we're seeing, the benefits so outweigh the risks, and it is a completely, all these vaccines that we have in the U.S. are completely safe. Yes, you hear about these rare, very rare side effects, but the chances of getting those effects, if you were to get COVID disease itself, are much, much higher.
So if I decided before I only needed one vaccine, you mentioned why it's important to get two. What if I got the vaccine, you know, first of a dose 4 months ago? Do I have to start all over again, or what's the advice around that? I really don't want to start all over again.
So even if you miss that typical window, you know, 3 or 4 weeks, it's fine to just pick up where you left off. So no need to restart.
If I could still get COVID, everybody's talking about the variant, you know, you can still transmit it, you can still get it. So what's the point of getting the vaccine?
So people that are vaccinated, they have about, it's like a 0.0004, less than 0.004% chance of getting hospitalized, and a 0.0001% chance of dying, which is, again, about 1,000 times less than if you did not get the vaccine. So even though, yes, you still may get COVID, it is likely, and it's less likely that you get it in the first place, but if you get it, it's less likely to be severe, and certainly a lot less likely of any chance of dying or anything like that.
Hopefully we can get some more people vaccinated so we really can get out of this COVID cycle that we keep to be in. So thank you so much for your time today. Appreciate it.
My pleasure.